Hi, Dr. Silverstein. I came in today because loud noises are really bothering me. It seems like I hear things all the time that other people don't even notice. It's kind of like I have super hearing, but not in a good way. Is there something wrong with me?
Well, you may have a condition called hyperacusis, and it occurs in about 7 to 15% of the population, where the normal sounds that we hear, that normal people hear, bother you a lot because your inner ear is hypersensitive to the sounds coming in. And so many times these people that have this hyperacusis have to use earplugs in their ear to cut out the sound of the environment so they can live and participate in life things. These people that have hyperacusis have to leave a restaurant. They can't stand the noise in a restaurant. They can't stand the sound in the movies. They're withdrawn, and they stop going into public places, and they try to be in as quiet a place as they can.
How is hyperacusis diagnosed? How would you know that I have this?
Okay, so the way we do it is we, again, take a careful history to find out what's really bothering you, because there are other types of problems in the inner ear, such as mesophonia, which is a dislike of a certain sound. You remember when you were a kid, the teacher would put chalk on the board and it would scratch.
Yeah.
And everybody would, sort of cringe when they heard that scratching. Well, that's mesophonia, where somebody doesn't like a certain sound. And then there's another thing called recruitment, which is similar to hyperacusis, but it only occurs in patients with hearing loss. And when the sound gets to a certain level where they can hear it, all of a sudden the sound jumps up. And that's called recruitment. So that's important to delineate what you have, whether it's recruitment, mesophonia, or hyperacusis, because the treatment that we invented will only help with the hyperacusis. Before we do the treatment, we have to do a couple tests on you. So we do what we call a loudness discomfort level. And we put you in a booth and we slowly increase the sound to your ear till you can't stand it. And you and I, the normal people, can stand 90 to 100 decibels of sound. And whereas the person with hyperacusis, they score anywhere below 90 decibels. So when we put the sound in at, say, 70 decibels, they say, I can't stand it, and we have to stop. And then we get a readout on each frequency of hearing of where how sensitive they are to each sound. We also have the patient fill in a questionnaire, which then helps us diagnose and tell us how severe the hyperacusis is. Patients with hyperacusis usually score around 35 to 40. 40 is the top. And after treatment, hopefully the number will go down to 15s or 20s, showing improvement.
So if my tests come back,
right,
and say that I do have hyperacusis, is there a treatment that you mentioned? Is that something that could help me?
We can offer them a procedure that I invented about 7 years ago. And this is a minor procedure, minimally invasive procedure, outpatient, where we take a little bit of tissue from above the ear here and place it in the below the eardrum on the little bones of hearing, the little stapes bone, and place it on the round window membrane, which moves when the sound vibrations come into the middle ear. What that does is it dampens the sound waves coming into the inner ear. And by dampening the sound waves, the ability to stand, tolerate loud sounds is improved.
So is this procedure painful? Is this a major surgery?
This is a minor procedure. It's almost painless. Sometimes patients take a little Tylenol after the surgery for a day. They have a little packing in their ear for a week. And then we take the packing out after a week. And it's usually a very minor procedure.
Are there any side effects I should be concerned about?
Well, like in any surgery, we always worry about hearing loss after an operation or infection, and that hasn't occurred in any of our patients. We've done about 30 patients now. The taste nerve runs right through the middle ear, right where we're operating. And it's a taste nerve that just involves one portion of the tongue that if you stretch it or touch it, you may get a metallic taste on your tongue, which is temporary for a few months. And this hasn't really occurred very often either.
How long until I'll notice a difference in my hearing after the procedure?
Well, your hearing should stay the same as what it was before the surgery, but to be able to tolerate loud sounds usually occurs in different times from different people. In other words, some people, right after you take the packing out, they'll notice a difference. You have to wait several weeks or several months. And it seems that our research has shown that over months, the ear becomes more tolerable to loud sounds over time.
Are the results permanent?
We don't know that for sure, but our oldest patient, who is our star patient that started all this research, is about 8 years now and still doing beautifully, and he's very happy with the result.
So this is a research study. Are other places doing the procedure, or is it just at the Silverstein Institute?
Other doctors can do it. In a research setting, we're now putting together a multi-center study with a number of the fellows that we've trained. About five or six fellows are going to do a similar procedure that I've been doing. And we're going to put the data all together from all our patients and then report that.
That sounds really promising and really exciting. I'm hoping that you can help people like me and help us to have a better quality of life.
I hope so.
Thank you, doctor.